Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you a simple example on how to use MVC and server-side rendering using NestJS with Pug and Handlebars as the template engines for the view. And if you have a WordPress website or if you are planning to have one, check out Elementor. Elementor is the best page builder for WordPress. You can download it for free. There is a link in the description below this video. Remember to share, like, and subscribe to the channel. And let's get started. Okay, so far we've been working on a RESTful API. We created a controller here to handle different HTTP methods of our shop's API. We implemented the GET, POST, PUT, etc. And now what we're going to do is we're going to reuse this controller, but in a different way. So in order to create our web application doing the rendering on the server, we need to create a couple of folders first. We are going to create a public folder where we're going to store the CSS files, the fab icons, some images, logos, the robot file, etc. And we are also going to create a new folder. We are going to call it views, where we are going to include the HTML templates, and we're going to use two template engines. The first one is going to be Pug. index.pug. So here, Here we are going to include the HTML using this template engine, and we're going to create another one that is going to be index.hbs, where we're going to use handlebars. Handlebars is a superset of mustache, and Pug was previously known as shade, the shade framework. And here we are going to create, I'm going to create a new folder actually, just to keep things organized. I'm going to move these files there. So we are going to use our shops controller, that is this one. And I'm going to keep those views within the shops folder just to be consistent with the naming and the structure. Okay. The next thing that we need to do is we need to update, let me close this. And we need to update our main.ts file so we can include, we can set these folders, the public and the views folder in the application. So we're going to use Express and we need to make some changes here. Here we need to use the Nest Express application. And we're gonna pass the app module. And we need to import that class. Import. I'm going to copy the class name. And we need to import this from NestJS Platform Express. And now we have to associate these different folders, our static assets folder and our views folder. So app.use static asset, and we need to pass the public directory, and we are going to use join, we're going to use the dir name, this is a reserved word, and we're going to position this on one level above the current file, and we're going to pass the file, the folder name that is public. And we need to import the join function. Okay, and now I need to associate the views directory using set base views dir. And this is gonna be pretty much the same. Instead of public, it's going to be views. And we should also associate the view engine. App.setViewEngine. And we're going to start using Pug. Okay, the next step is going to be installing actually the view engine. I'm going to install two. I'm going to install Pug and Handlebars. So we can use Pug or we can use HBS, that is Handlebars. So I'm going to run npm install save Pug and Handlebars. Okay, the next thing that we need to do is we need to go to the main module of the application, and I'm going to remove this default controller, this service. We are not going to use those. I'm going to remove these dependencies here. And now I'm going to make some changes in the jobs controller. I'm going to use this method where we get the list of jobs. And I'm going to rename this function as root. I'm going to remove the type. And I'm going to add a decorator to associate the view. The decorator is render. And I'm going to pass the view here. That is going to be index. Sorry. That is going to be shops slash index. So it's going to be actually these views that we created here within the views folder. Okay, let's go back. And here what I'm going to do, I'm going to change this a little bit because this is returning a promise. And this is actually an array of shops like that. And let's go back. So I'm going to make some changes here. And I'm going to add a then statement. Where I'm going to receive a result. And if I get results, I need to return and a specific structure and a specific model that is required to be rendered in the view. I need to return an object, and this object needs to include some attribute so I can access it from the view. So if we get any results, I'm going to return this object. I'm going to add an attribute, create an object with just one attribute that is going to be shops, and it's going to include this array of shops. But if we don't get any results, I'm just going to return an empty array. It's going to be like this. Shops and an empty array. Shops. Like that. Okay, and now we can work on our views that are going to render this model. This one. Okay, let's open. First, let's work with the index using Pug. So HTML, head, we're going to assign a title. We're going to call it Pug Shop Index. And we need to add a body. And we're going to add a list. And each item of this list is going to be a job that we are going to get from this method. Okay, and here I'm going to iterate through the collection that we get. That is actually this collection, this shops collection. And here is going to be each shop in shops. Shops is the attribute name of that model. And here we are going to create a list item where we are going to include the shop title and the salary. Like that. Okay, let's try this. Again, run, start.dev. And now let's open the browser in localhost 3000/shops/, and yeah, we should be able to get, okay, something is wrong. Let's see what's going on. Oh, okay, my bad. This is shops/index. Okay, let's save this. Let's try again. And here we get undefined. Okay, some typo there. Let me check. Yeah, it's not tile, it's title. Okay, let's refresh. Okay, and here we get all the elements. I didn't show you the database, but if we go to the database, let me open the database. Here is the shops collection, and we have these four documents. C++ developer, C developer, C sharp developer, and JavaScript developer. All these four. Okay, let's close all this. Let's go back. And now let's create. First, let's change the view engine to handlebars. And let's create our HTML template here. So this needs to be HTML, the type HTML. HTML. Let's add header, head, title. Let's call it HBS. Check the name just to shop index. Let's add the body. And here we are going to create an order list. And we're going to iterate each element of the shops collection. Shops. I need to close this. Each statement, and within this, I'm going to add a list item, and here I can access the attribute of each shop, like this, title, and the salary. Okay, we have the handlebars view engine assigned. So if we refresh, we should get a different title, HBS shop index, but the same list. Let's try this now. And yes, we get the same list, and we get HBS for handlebars and shop index. Okay, that's pretty much all I have for today. Thank you guys for watching, and I see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.